Hey guys, it's finally here, the 2019 CONCACAF Gold Cup Tournament. It is here and it's gonna be glorious. I just know it, I could feel it in my bones. I think Canada is gonna do great. I think Mexico is always gonna be strong as ever. I think the US might be able to bounce back. There's so many great storylines. I'm gonna break it all down right here in my official 2019 CONCACAF Gold Cup preview video. But before we get started, make sure you hit that like button if you like this video and make sure to remember to hit that red subscribe button so you can see more content just like this. Now let's get started with Group A. Now the first group here is Group A in the tournament, which of course has Martinique, Cuba, Canada, and Mexico in this first group here. And I think it's going to be a good group. I think Mexico is obviously probably the best team coming in this tournament in the CONCACAF. I have no way, shape, or form think that they're going to finish anything lower than first in this group. I think they will top the group and will probably be about 3-0 in the group, or even 2 wins and 1 draw. But I do think they do top the group. I wouldn't say easily, but they do have a good shot of pretty much dominating this group from start to finish. And I think they finished first place in Group A. And I think Martinique, I think though they're still a young developing soccer type country coming into this tournament. I don't think that they can make a huge splash against even like countries like Cuba and Canada. I think are a little bit ahead of them. Still, I think unfortunately Martinique finishes fourth in this group. And I think the real battle here will actually be for second between Cuba and Canada. I think this is gonna be a good test though for Canada and their young Canadian men's national team that's kind of rebuilding right now. And this is gonna be a good first big test for John Herdman's side and John Herdman altogether. But I think at the end of the day, I do think Canada and their young talent will be able to at least overcome this first little obstacle here and finish second place, which means Cuba finishes third. And of course the top two teams in each group will make it onto the knockout stage, which is the quarterfinals. So I think the Group A winner will be Mexico, and I think the runner-up and going into the quarterfinals will be Canada. Here in Group B, we have Nicaragua, Haiti, Bermuda, and Costa Rica. And I think in this little group here, I do see Costa Rica going a perfect 3-0 in group stages and pulling off a first place finish in Group B and being the winners of Group B. I do unfortunately see Nicaragua kind of having a bit of a struggling group here, and I think they'll finish fourth in this group. And I think the battle in for second place and for runner-up will be between Bermuda and Haiti. I do see out of any of the runner-up spots, I do think this one, I think Haiti, despite being a top, I think 20 nation in the CONCACAF, for sure, I think they might even struggle against Bermuda a little bit here. But I think ultimately they should be able to edge out Bermuda. Bermuda, I think, will finish third, and I think Haiti will finish second, and Haiti and Costa Rica will both move on to the quarterfinals. Group C here has Curacao, Jamaica, El Salvador, and Honduras. And I think this is kind of going to be your group of death for this year's tournament. I think, unfortunately, Curacao, because they're a bit of a smaller country with maybe not as much depth, I want to say, in terms of talent, I think they finished fourth, unfortunately, in this group. I think El Salvador will probably push some of the upper echelon countries in this group here. But I do think Honduras will go 3-0 and finish first place atop Group C and top that group. I think third is El Salvador, and I think Jamaica, which is kind of like a trap team here because they always seem to be able to pull off wins against really big countries, and because of that, they're one of the top countries now in the CONCACAF region. I think they'll finish second, and I do see Honduras and Jamaica moving it on to the quarterfinals. Group D has United States, Trinidad and Tobago, Panama, and Guyana. And in this group, I think Group D here, I do see Guyana unfortunately finishing fourth in this group. I know I'm super sorry, but I do think they'll finish fourth. I think Trinidad and Tobago, I think, you know, might look a little bit impressive at times, but I do unfortunately see them finishing third in this group, although I do see them pushing United States and Panama even for the top two spots in this one. You know what, on second thought, I did say the group of death would be Group C. Actually, now I'm kind of talking myself into it. I kind of actually see Group D being the group of death just because the US and their form coming into this isn't really the greatest. So I really think that anyone can win Group D. I do see the US finishing at least in the top two and making it onto the quarterfinals, but it's not a for sure set thing. I think that they could win Group D here. I think Panama can really push them. I think if Trinidad and Tobago can push them, I think that could open up a world of possibilities. Maybe even Guyana slips in there, who knows? But unfortunately, in my preview, I do think Guyana finishes fourth, Trinidad and Tobago finish third, and I do see Panama actually finishing second, and I think United States will finish first, and therefore Panama and United States will move on to the quarterfinals. Now with the group stages set in my predictions here, we move on to the quarterfinals that would play off those group stages, and now we'll see Canada versus Costa Rica, Haiti versus Mexico, Panama versus versus Honduras and U.S. versus Jamaica, which would be a rematch of the 2017 Gold Cup Finals. Now, starting over with Canada versus Costa Rica, I do think Canada will get a really good test here against Costa Rica. I don't, unfortunately, see them passing this test. I think they'll just get edged out by a more experienced, more talent, not really more talented, but for sure more experienced in these higher grade of CONCACAF tournaments in Costa Rica. I think Costa Rica is an upper echelon CONCACAF nation, and then Canada will get a good test and good learning experience from it, but I do see them losing for a second tournament in a row in the quarterfinals. So Costa Rica will be Canada, move on to the semis. I think Mexico versus Haiti will be a decent matchup. I think at the end of the day though, Mexico should be able to win this one and move on to the semifinals, being out Haiti in the quarterfinals here. And I think over in Honduras versus Panama should be another really good matchup to look forward to. But I do see Honduras, who's one of the better nations in the CONCACAF, kind of like Costa Rica here, beating Panama in this one. It will be close, but I do see Honduras winning it and moving on to the semifinals. And finally, Jamaica versus the U.S. I think actually will be probably one of the big matchups, along with Canada, Costa Rica, to watch in the quarterfinals. And because the U.S. is run of form, I mean, if they're top form, they should be able to win this one. But Jamaica, like I said, in the group stages, was one of those trap teams that can beat anybody on any given day. And Jamaica did go all the way to the finals 2 years ago when they beat Canada in the quarterfinals and Mexico in the semifinals. And I actually think they'll pose a bit of an upset this year as well, beating out the Americans in the quarterfinals and moving on to the semifinals. So from quarterfinals, we now move on to the semifinals with two really good matchups, with Jamaica versus Honduras and Mexico versus Costa Rica. I think these are two really good matchups here. I think a lot of people are going to have a lot of fun watching these two matchups in the semifinals for a big battle for a spot in the finals of the CONCACAF Gold Cup tournament. I do see Mexico, Costa Rica going probably the penalty kicks. Will be really tight, low scoring game, possibly like a 2-1 or 1-0 finish. I do ultimately see Mexico just edging out Costa Rica in that crazy matchup. So Mexico, in my predictions, will go to the finals. And in the other semifinal matchup, Jamaica versus Honduras, I do unfortunately see Jamaica, as great as they were 2 years ago in 2017, causing mayhem, going all the way to the finals, and this year going all the way to the semifinals, in my prediction. I unfortunately do see them exiting out right here in the semifinals, losing probably in a score of 1-0 or 2-1 to Honduras. So there you go. My finals will be Honduras versus Mexico. So here we go, the 2019 CONCACAF Gold Cup Final, and I think it'll be Honduras versus Mexico. And at the end of the day, it'll be a tight one, but it'll end up being a 2-1 win for Mexico. I do see Mexico, after having kind of a bit of an upset loss in the semifinals to Jamaica 2 years ago, coming back, bouncing back, and winning this year's tournament. It also kind of helps that Canada is still a young team on the rise, not, you know, experienced enough maybe with this current crop of talent to go all the way and challenge for the title this year at least. And of course, with the U.S. kind of just being blah in terms of form currently a little bit, and of course missing out in 2018 on the World Cup, and this year kind of coming, you know, 50-50, I think it's just flip a coin and that's how good they'll play this year in the tournament. It's kind of tough though, unfortunately for the Americans. I do think they'll make it to the quarterfinals but lose. I think Canada will make it to the quarterfinals and lose, and I think Mexico though will go all the way and win 2-1 in the finals and win the CONCACAF Gold Cup. Alright guys, that was my video this week. Let me know down in the comment section below, who do you think will win the 2019 CONCACAF tournament? Do you think it's Mexico? Do you think it's US, Canada, Honduras, Costa Rica? Let me know down below. And of course, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, that thumbs up. Shows me that you guys like videos just like this. And of course, if you want to see more content just like this about the Canadian Premier League or Canadian men's national team, make sure you consider hitting that red subscribe button. If you hit that bell notification button, you get notified each and every time I drop a brand new episode just like this one. And you can also watch my content over at northernstarting11.com. I have a link for that down in the description below. You're going to want to click that now so you can feed that hunger in your stomach for some Canadian men's, Canadian women's, and even Canadian Premier League stuff, news, notes, everything you need to know is all right there in that link. So you're going to click that link now. You're going to find it all in that one place, nice and convenient and easy just for you. So click that link below. And until next time, guys, thank you for watching.